Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Welcome back to 30 Ways in 30 Days. Today's way, inshallah, we'll discuss the use of time as a way to Jannah, using our time wisely. Just before the month, we were discussing of how Ramadan was coming up and how to prepare for Ramadan. And now, subhanAllah, here we are discussing the end of Ramadan. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ayyamun ma'dudat. A limited amount of days, and sure enough, it was limited. Look how fast it passed. And this is kind of an analogy to our lives. Look how many years have passed of our lives already. You know, how fast it went. Time is so important that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has sworn by it in many different ayat. وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَغْشَى, by Allah swearing by the night. وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا تَجَلَّى, right? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He swears by the day. والضحى, the time of the day, والعصر, والفجر, all these different times of the day, Allah is swearing by it to show us the importance of time. When He swears by something, He's giving it significance. Also in many ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encourages us to use our time wisely by telling us to rush to good deeds. وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ, you know, rush to do the forgiveness of your Lord. Rush to the forgiveness of your Lord. فَاسْتَبِقُوا الْخَيْرَاتِ, race with one another in good deeds. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is showing us a sense of urgency that life is too short. Take advantage of it before it's too late. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, take advantage of five before five. Your health before your sickness, your wealth before your poverty, your free time before it's occupied, your life before your death, or your youth before your old age, and your life before your death. You know, most of these aspects have to do with using your time wisely before it's too late. Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah, he said, Ya ibn Adam, innaka, أو إنما أنت أيام وكلما يذهب يوم يذهب بعضك. O child of Adam, you are nothing but a bunch of days, and every time a day goes, so does a part of you. Another poet, he said, إن لنفرح بالأيام نقطعها وكل يوم مضى جزء من العمر. He said that, you know, we are happy with all the days that are passing by us, that we cut, you know, that we pass by a day, we cut off a day, we finish a day. We're happy, you know, when we're young, can't wait till we drive a car, for example, and then we get there, and then we can't wait to graduate from high school. We can't wait to, you know, graduate from college, or get married, or get a job, or have kids, etc. But we're always, as we're rushing to get to these goals and hoping that it'll come quickly, it's actually part of our lives that are disappearing. You know, every day that passes is a part of your life that's gone, that can never return. So the Muslim should try to use his time in the best of manner. You know, the Prophet ﷺ said that two things people fail to take advantage of the most are good health and free time. As-sahhatu wal-firagh. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he used to say that he didn't regret something more than losing time. Basically, he said, مَا نَدَمْتُ عَلَى شَيْءٍ نَدَمِي عَلَى يَوْمٍ غَرَبَتْ فِيهِ الشَّمْسِ نَقَصَ فِيهِ الْأَجَلِ أَوْ نَقَصَ فِيهِ أَجَلِي وَلَمْ يَزِيدْ فِيهِ عَمَلِي. That I don't regret anything more than a day that has passed, you know, when the sun has set, the day has passed, in which my lifespan has been decreased and my actions have not increased. So this is to show the way the Salaf were so concerned with using their time wisely. You know, on the Day of Judgment, we will be saying, it will feel like a day or part of a day in this dunya. يَوْمًا أَوْ بَعْضَ يَوْمٍ أَوْ سَاعَةً مِنْ نَهَارٍ, or like a part, an hour of the day, or a couple hours of the day. Our whole lives will feel like a day, or less than a day. Can you imagine that? How much of this day are we using in the obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in doing good deeds? Time is your capital. You know, the more you use your time wisely, you're investing capital for the akhirah. And that's the best of investments that you can never compare with investment in the dunya. You know, time is precious, more precious than wealth, because you can never get it back. Wealth you may lose and get back in the dunya, but time you can never get it back. It's your life that's gone away. وَالْوَقْتُ أَنْفَسُ مَا عُنِيتُ بِحِفْظِهِ وَأَرَاهُ أَسْهَلَ مَا عَلَيْكَ يَضِيعُ. الْوَزِيرُ الصَّالِحُ يَحْيَى بْنُ زَهِيرٍ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى, he used to say that time is the most precious thing that you can basically spend in protecting it, using it wisely. However, I see it the most easy for you to lose, showing us the importance of time. Another famous poem, a man was regretting how he lost his youth, you know, how he didn't take advantage of time. بكيت على شبابي بدمع عيني فلم يفيد البكاء ولا النحيب ألا ليت شباب يعود يوما فأخبره بما فعل المشيب. He said that I cried upon my youth, you know, until, you know, as the tears were coming down my cheeks, down from my eyes, but the crying and the wailing were of no benefit. I wish that my youth can come return to me so I can tell it what my old age has done. So imagine, you know, the regret this man is showing that he lost his youth, he can never get it back. You know, but the scholars, they say that yesterday or the past is history. You can't really, you know, catch up with it. And the future is unknown. So you only really have today to take advantage of the time before it's too late. You know, one of the cartoon characters, they say yesterday is history and tomorrow is a mystery. And today is a present, basically a gift, the gift of life. It is the gift of life. It's the gift of time that Allah has given us. So how are we going to use it wisely? You know, try your best. Inshallah, even if you fell short this month, you still have life in you. So you still have time to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to come back to Allah. You still can manage your time. Look at the successful people, even in the dunya, and especially the righteous ones, how they use their times wisely to be successful, right? The prophets, alayhim salat, how did they spend their time? You know, remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When they weren't doing different works, they were remembering Allah. They were asking for forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They were making tawbah, right? Spending time with the righteous, spending time with scholars, seeking knowledge. Using, you know, don't waste any time, because every time that's wasted will be a form of regret on the Day of Judgment. And we'll wish that we can take it back, but we can't, because it's never going to come back. Once you're finished, once the day is, judgment has come, then that's it, khalas, there's no more time left. So take advantage of it before it's too late, as our Prophet ﷺ taught us. Use this time wisely. Tomorrow, inshallah, will be Eid, and I will have a 30th way, inshallah. A easy way, a good way, a nice way for the appropriate day of Eid. Jazakum Allah khairan. And if I don't see you then, Eid Mubarak. May Allah accept from us our good deeds, our prayers, our du'as, our actions, inshallah. And may He forgive us our sins and write us with those who enter into Jannah. Jazakum Allah khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.